Now, I don't know about you, but every time I come across the halting problem, I kind of buy the mathematical arguments, but I still feel somewhat cheated. It's important, I think, to realize what is being implied by undecidability and what is not being implied. So informally, all that the undecidability of the halting problem says is that you cannot analyze every aspect of computation using computation. So let's say this program here is supposed to solve the halting problem. So this would be the program halt here. The difficulty lies in the fact that halt is required not only to be able to say what one given program, program 2, does, and of course we'll assume there's also an input, but basically it's supposed to be able to say this for an infinite number of programs. Now, the following is by no means a scientific explanation, but I think it's a good way to think about it. If we have the requirement that halt must be able to look at every other problem here, then halt will also be part of this list. So somewhere in that stack of programs, you will have halt. Now, if you say halt must be more complex, and again, this is not a scientific explanation, must be more complex than any program it's looking at, well, then halt must be more complex than halt itself, which of course leads to an infinite cycle of complexity. So here we kind of have this spiral of infinity, which of course cannot be. So there's the error right there. And again, this is just an intuition, a way which I like to think about it. You may find other ways more convenient. What I find is with undecidability, and especially the halting problem, there's a lot of misunderstandings and pitfalls. And actually, I would now like to go with you through one of the most common pitfalls regarding the halting problem and its undecidability.